Hello everyone, myself Dr. Kanta from GGDST College, Palwal. In this video lecture on Funaria Part 1, we are going to study about the morphology, anatomy, and vegetative reproduction in Funaria. In this lecture, we will discuss about the classification, occurrence, gametophytic plant body, vegetative structure, internal structure, and vegetative reproduction in Funaria. Let's first see about the systematic position or classification of Funaria. Funaria belongs to division Bryophyta, class Bryopsida, that includes mosses. It is the largest class of bryophytes that includes more than 700 genera and about 14,000 species. Subclass Bryti, that include majority of true mosses. Order Funariales, family Funariaceae, and genus Funaria. Now next, with regard to occurrence or habitat where this Funaria occur, usually this Funaria, it is a cosmopolitan. Cosmopolitan means that it is found all across or most of the world in an appropriate habitat. Now it found both in tropical as well as temperate region in the world, and there are about 210 species of Funaria. Out of them, 15 species have been reported in India. It usually grow on moist shady places like damp soil, moist rocks, shady banks. Moreover, they can also grow on tree trunks and moist walls. The most common species of Funaria is the Funaria hygrometrica. Now these plants are known as the cord mosses. Cord means rope-like structure. Now as you can see in this picture, now here it is a long thread-like structure. It is the seta. Now the seta hai is Funaria ka. It is having a hygroscopic nature, means now it is untwisted when the environmental condition is moist, and it becomes twisted when it is a dry condition. So due to this its twisting and untwisted nature, it resembles to that of the rope, and these are known as the cord mosses. Moreover, the term Funaria, it is derived from the Latin word that is funis, which mean rope. So they are known as the cord mosses. And the most common site of occurrence, jahan par ye bahut amount mein milta hai, that is recently burned soil. Ab is tarah ki habitat mein actually hota kya hai? There is an increased availability of soil nutrients, and that will favor the profuse growth of this Funaria. So next, we will discuss about the structure of gametophytic plant body of Funaria. As you all know that in case of bryophytes, the dominant plant body is the gametophyte. The same is the case in case of Funaria, as it is an example of bryophyte. Now the gametophytic plant body of Funaria, it mainly consisting of two stages. First is the protonemal stages, and second is the gametophore. Now this protonema stage jo hai iski ye kya hai, iski juvenile stage hai, aur gametophore jo hai iski adult stage hai. Now first we will see the protonema or the juvenile stage. Jo ye protonema stage hai iski, this is formed by the germination of spores. Spores ke germination se ye stage banti hai. Now this protonema, it is ephemeral. Ephemeral means whose lifespan is very small, and that usually creep on the ground. Moreover, it is also showing the heterotrichous habit. Heterotrichous habit kya hoti hai? heterotrichous habit. Now, where there are the two system, one is the erect system and another is the prostate. Now, this is the prostate system that grow on the substratum, or this is the erect system. तो जहां जिस भी प्लांट के पास दोनों सिस्टम होंगे दैट इज शोइंग द हेटरोट्राइकस हैबिट. नाउ दिस प्रोटोनिमाइट इज शोइंग हेटरोट्राइकस हैबिट. नाउ दिस इफ वी लुक एट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस प्रोटोनिमा ऑफ फिनेरिया, नाउ यू कैन क्लियरली सी दैट इन केस ऑफ दिस प्रोटोनिमा स्टेज ऑफ फिनेरिया इट इज फिलामेंटस मल्टीसेलुलर. मोर ओवर इट इज ब्रांच्ड. और ब्रांचिंग जो पैटर्न है इसके अंदर इट इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स. दो तरह के इसके अंदर ब्रांचेस होती हैं. फर्स्ट इज द क्लोरोनिमल ब्रांचेस एंड सेकंड इज द राइजोइडल ब्रांचेस. जो क्लोरोनिमल ब्रांचेस हैं, ये देखो अगर आप देखें ये तो डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन है प्रोटोनिमा की एंड दिस इज द एक्चुअल पिक्चर दैट वी कैन सी अंडर द माइक्रोस्कोप. नाउ ये क्लोरोनिमल ब्रांचेस हैं और ये राइजोइडल, दीज राइजोइडल ब्रांचेस दे आर आल्सो नोन एज द क्यूलोनिमा. नाउ इन केस ऑफ क्लोरोनिमल ब्रांचेस द सेल्स आर कंपैरेटिवली स्मॉल, वेयर एज द सेल्स ऑफ दीज क्यूलोनिमल और राइजोइडल ब्रांचेस दे आर लार्ज. अनदर डिफरेंस विद रेफरेंस टू इट्स सेल वॉल, द सेल वॉल ऑफ क्लोरोनिमल ब्रांचेस इट इज कलरलेस. Whereas in case of rhizoidal branches, when it is young, it is colorless, but it mature. When it mature, it become brown in color. Another difference is that in case of chloronema, the cells having this cross wall and these cross wall, these are perpendicular. देखो यहाँ पर clear दिख रहा perpendicular. However, these chloronemal rhizoidal branches they have the this. Oblique cell walls. So these are the few differences which are present in the chloronemal or the culonemal branches. Now, when these branches they grow up to the certain period of time, then will they start producing the buds, bud-like structure. Now these buds give rise to the adult gametophyte. यानी कि जो second phase है gametophore. और एडल्ट गैमेटोफाइट ये बनता किससे है, बाय द बर्ड्स विच प्रोड्यूस्ड ऑन दिस प्रोटोनिमल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द मॉसेस. राइट, एक्चुअली होता क्या है इसमें कि जो ये फिलामेंटस स्ट्रक्चर है इसमें दे कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ द बर्ड्स एंड ईच बर्ड दे गिव राइज टू द एडल्ट गैमेटोफाइट. सो दिस फ्यूनेरिया प्लांट दे ग्रो इन ए क्लोज टफ्ट. नाउ इन जनरल एट ए ग्लांस यू कैन सी दैट जैसे हम इसको प्रोटोनिमल स्टेजेस देखते हैं तो हमें लगता है कि जैसे इट इज रिजेंबलिंग विद दैट ऑफ द फिलामेंटस एल्गी, बट देयर आर ए लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द प्रोटोनिमा ऑफ मॉसेस एंड द फिलामेंटस ग्रीन एल्गी. नाउ हियर वी विल सी नंबर वन, प्रोटोनिमा ऑफ मॉसेस दे आर शोइंग द हेटरोट्राइकस हैबिट. राइट, जैसे मैंने बताया कि आपके दो उसमें सिस्टम होते हैं इरेक्ट और प्रोस्टेट सिस्टम. इन ग्रीन एल्गी there is a wide range of habit, matlab unbranched bhi ho sakte hain, branched bhi ho sakte hain, or they can even be heterotrichous. Now with reference to chloroplast, protonema they consisting of chloroplast they are either discoid or rounded shape, but in algae again there are lot of variations. The chloroplast may be spiral as in case of Spirogyra, collar shaped as in case of Eulothrix, star shaped as in case of Zygnema, or it can even reticulated as in case of Oligonium. Now another important feature, in case of Protonema, chloroplast they are not associated with pyrenoite, but it is a common feature that in case of green algae, pyrenoids are usually associated with the chloroplast. And the last difference is the regarding rhizoidal branches. They are having the cross wall, the important characteristic, they are having the cross wall, and that cross wall it is a showing the oblique shape, that is a diagonal. However, no oblique septa has been reported in green algae. So by By looking at these differences between most protonema and filament of green algae, now we can clear cut differentiate between both. Now, as we are discussing the gametophytic plant Podiophenaria, जिसमें बताया कि आपके दो इसके अंदर स्टेजेस हैं, एक प्रोटोनिमा जो कि जुवेनाइल स्टेजेस, जुवेनाइल जो इसकी स्टेज है जो हमने डिस्कस किया अभी. नाउ नेक्स्ट जो स्टेज है जिसको हम एडल्ट गैमेटोफाइट कहते हैं, एडल्ट गैमेटोफाइट या फिर जो गैमेटोफोर. नाउ इट इज परसिस्टेंट. प्रोटोनिमा क्या थी? दैट इज एफीमेरल बट इट इज ए परसिस्टेंट एंड इरेक्ट. इट इज इरेक्ट. वो क्या थी? एफीमेरल थी और क्या थी? हेटरोट्राइकस थी. नाउ हियर इट इज ए इरेक्ट. नाउ ये बनता कैसे एडल्ट गैमेटोफाइट? ये जो बर्ड्स बनती है प्रोटोनिमा पे वही ग्रो करके मैंने बताया आपको गैमेटोफोर्स को प्रोड्यूस करती है. नाउ दीज गैमेटोफोर और एडल्ट गैमेटोफाइट ऑफ फ्यूनेरिया दे कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ थ्री पार्ट्स राइजोइड्स एंड दिस एक्सियल सिस्टम एंड थर्ड वन इज द लीफ. नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट विद द राइजोइड. नाउ द राइजोइड्स ऑफ फ्यूनेरिया, नाउ these are thin branched and moreover they are having the oblique septum as the same situation we have observed in the rhizoidal branches of protonema. Second, these rhizoids, they may contain the oil droplets, and if they exposed to light then they can also develop the chlorophyll. When the rhizoids are young, they are usually colorless, but at maturity, similar to that of rhizoidal branches, they can develop the brown color. And the main important function of rhizoid is that they help in the absorption of water and the minerals. Now, you have also studied the rhizoids of Markentia, and now you studied the structure of rhizoid of Fineria. Now there is a, let's see what is the basic difference between these two rhizoids of Markentia and Fineria. Now first important point is that in case of Markentia, the rhizoid, these are unicellular, and in case of Fineria it is multicellular, right? These unicellular jo rhizoids hai Markentia ke, wo arise kahan se hote hain? They arise from the epidermal cells. Epidermal cells that is lying below the thallus. However, in Fineria, these rhizoids, they arise either from the base of the adult gametophore axis or from the protonema. Now, in Markentia, there are two types of rhizoid. One is a smooth-walled, this one, and the another is a tuberculated or that is having the paste-like ingrowth, right? These two type of rhizoids have been observed in Markentia. And in Fineria, there is only one type of rhizoid. Now, next difference is that the rhizoid of Markentia, they are always unbranched. And there is a no complexity, that is simple. While here, the rhizoids are always branched. And they show the three order of magnitude. Three order of magnitude means, now this is the first order of magnitude that arise directly from the, suppose yahan par ye main axis hai, uski base se jo hai ye first order ki jo hai iske andar rhizoids arise hote hain, then they further give rise to the branches and these are of the secondary order, and these branches again further divided to give rise to fine rhizoids which is of third order. So this is how the rhizoids of Fineria are different from rhizoids of Markentia. Now the second part, adult gametophyte ka jo humne bataya ki three parts hain, first rhizoid and the second is the stem. Now let's see what are the characteristic or morphological structure of the stem or the main axis of Fineria. Now main axis of Fineria jo hai ye kya hai? It is a erect hai and it is a branched. Now these branches jo hai iski kaisi hai? These are extra, sabse important baat hai, these branches are extra axillary, means they never arise from the axil of the leaf or branch. However, they arise below the basis, or we can say from the basis. Basis se jo hai अराइज होती हैं एंड मोर ओवर दीज आर मोनोपोडियल दैट इज द लेटरल एंड नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ एडल्ट गैमेटोफाइट और गैमेटोफोर इज द लीव्स लीव्स यू कैन सी इन दिस डायग्राम दैट द लीव्स आर अरेंज्ड spirally in the lower branches and at the apex they are present in a group or crown ke form mein jo hai present hoti hain aur each leaf they are having a flat structure bright green in color and these are sessile sessile means usually you see you know ki leaf jo hai wo kahan se arise hote hain either they arise from the branch or they can arise from the main branch main axis but they are having the petiole or the stalk at their end but if the leaves they are not having any petiole or stalk then such type of leaf that is known as the sessile so in case of Fineria the leaf it is the sessile their shape is it is ovoid shape and having a single midrib in the center so this is the basic we can say the morphological structure or the vegetative structure of the adult gametophyte Now next we will study about the anatomy or the internal structure of the different parts of Fineria. Now let's first study about the anatomy of main axis or the stem. Now the internal organization of stem it is very simple and it consisting of three parts. On the outer side, it consisting of a single layer of the cells, and the cells of these epidermis, these consisting of the chloroplast, and there is no stomata and no cuticle is existing. And this epidermis, it is followed by the cortex. Epidermis के बाद क्या है? Cortex, and this is mainly consisting of the parenchymatous or we can say the living cells jo hai iske andar present hote hain outer jo cortex ke jo layers hain cortex ki outer layers of cortex jo hain when in young condition they usually consisting of the chloroplast but as the axis mature then these cells these parenchymatous cells they become thick walled and moreover they lack the chloroplast and in the center there are present the vertically elongated cells jo cells hain inki wall jo hai kya hoti hai that is thick and these all cells they are compactly arranged without any intercellular spaces and they often lack the protoplast means ki ye kaise hain these are the dead cells as they are not having any protoplast and the main important function jo hai in cells ka kya hai they help in the conduction or that's why they are known as the central conducting strands now next second we will discuss about the internal structure of the leaf leaf as you know it is a flat structure in which in the center there is present the midrib and on the side these are known as the wings right and internal structure shows that ki the middle part jo hai midrib ka right this middle part now it is this middle part jo hai iska it consisting of large number of cells whereas this wing part of the leaf that is consisting of the single layer of cells moreover in the midrib part mein jo middle part hai center mein dikh rahe hain aapko these are the some thick walled cells that act as a conducting strand and again they help in the conduction whereas the cells of wing these are polygonal or har ek cell mein kya hai they consisting of large amount of chloroplast now at last we will discuss about the reproduction in case of Fineria now these Fineria it reproduce by means of both method that is vegetatively as well as reproductively however in this video lecture we will discuss only the vegetative reproduction in case of Fineria now here in Fineria the vegetative reproduction take place by means following ways first in case of primary proteinema. Primary proteinemas, these are the proteinema that develop directly from the germination of spores. Spores ki germination se bante hain. Now, jo filamentous structure hai primary proteinema ka, beech mein kya hai, sometimes they are having the few cells, those are colorless. And these intercalary cells which are colorless, they are known as the separation cells. Why they are separation cells? Because they become dead. Aur yahi wo jagah hai jahan se kya hai, the filament kya hai, it get broken down. And then each pieces of these filament, they have the capability to produce the young gametophore. Or then these will further grow and give rise to the adult gametophyte, ko jo hai ye produce karta hai. This, as in this primary proteinema, these separation cells, they help in the fragmentation. So this method is also called as the fragmentation method. The second way of vegetative reproduction is by means of secondary proteinema. इसका नाम सेकेंडरी इसलिए दिया है क्योंकि जो है इट इज नॉट फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम द जर्मिनेशन ऑफ स्पोर्स बट देर आर द अदर वेज आल्सो फ्रॉम वेयर द प्रोटोनिमा फॉर्म दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज द सेकेंडरी प्रोटोनिमा नाउ इन दिस केस व्हाट इज हैपनिंग कि समटाइम कुछ अगर इंजर्ड लीफ के सेल्स हैं या इंजर्ड एक्सिस के सेल जो हैं दे कैन आल्सो गिव राइज टू द फिलामेंटस स्ट्रक्चर एंड उस फिलामेंटस स्ट्रक्चर को हम क्या कहते हैं सेकेंडरी प्रोटोनिमा और दैट कैन बिहेव इन द सेम मैनर एज द प्राइमरी वन और ये भी क्या करेगा कि जो इसके ऊपर जो है देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ बर्ड्स एंड देन दीज बर्ड्स दे कैन गिव राइज टू द यंग गैमेटोफोर एंड देन मैच्योर गैमेटोफोर्स नाउ नेक्स्ट थर्ड बाय मीन्स ऑफ गैमी नाउ गैमी क्या है एक्चुअली गैमीज जो है दीज आर द टर्मिनल सेल्स दीज आर द टर्मिनल सेल्स ऑफ फिलामेंटस स्ट्रक्चर विच डेवलप्ड स्मॉल बर्ड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर और ये बर्ड लाइक जो स्ट्रक्चर है इसमें क्या है इनकी सेल वॉल क्या होती है थिन वॉल मोर ओवर दे हैविंग ए लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ क्लोरोफिल विद देम एंड दीज गैमे लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दे कैन गिव राइज टू द मैच्योर गैमेटोफोर स्ट्रक्चर आफ्टर डेवलपिंग और वी कैन से आफ्टर जर्मिनेटिंग इट कैन गिव राइज टू द मैच्योर गैमेटोफोर्स नाउ फोर्थ मेथड जो है इसके अंदर दैट इज बाय मीन्स ऑफ ट्यूबर एंड बल्बिस Now, जैसे यहाँ पर हमने देखा कि जो गैमीज हैं, गैमीज कहाँ बने हैं? They are formed on the filamentous structure और कौन सी क्लोरोनिमल ब्रांचेस? Moreover, sometimes such same gamete-like structure they can also be produced on the rhizoids, and these are known as either bulbils or tubers. They can also give rise to the mature gametophore. तो दोनों ही क्या हैं? गैमे और बल्बिल्स और ट्यूबर्स तीनों क्या हैं? सेम दे हैव द सेम टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर डिफरेंसेस क्या है कि गैमे वर्ड इट इज यूज्ड व्हेन द बर्ड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दे आर फॉर्म एट द अपेक्स ऑफ क्लोरोनिमल ब्रांचेस एंड व्हेन सेम स्ट्रक्चर गैमे लाइक स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्म ऑन द राइजोइड देन इट इज कॉल्ड बल्बिल्स और द ट्यूबर्स एंड द लास्ट मेथड ऑफ वेजिटेटिव प्रोडक्शन इज द एपोस्पोरी नाउ दिस एपोस्पोरी मींस हियर इन दिस केस अगेन देयर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेकेंडरी प्रोटोनिमा secondary that is not derived from the spores right jaise pehle humne padha tha usme case mein to wahan par kya tha secondary protonema that have been derived from the kahan se bane the wo that have been derived from the injured leaf ya fir injured axis se bana tha right now here sometime these filamentous or protonema structure that can be developed from the injured sporophyte kab banta hai fertilization ke baad so iska nature kya hai diploid तो एज ए रिजल्ट जो स्पोरोफाइट के जो सेल्स हैं वो क्या करते हैं दे कैन गिव राइज टू प्रोटोनिमा एंड दीज प्रोटोनिमा कैन फर्दर गिव राइज टू इन दीज प्रोटोनिमा कैन हैव टू गिव राइज टू द गैमेटोफोर यंग और मैच्योर फ्रॉम द जर्मिनेशन ऑफ द बर्ड्स ऑन दिस प्रोटोनिमा अब ये जो प्रोटोनिमा सेकेंडरी प्रोटोनिमा हम पढ़ रहे हैं जो स्पोरोफाइट से बने हैं या अर्लियर हमने जो पढ़ा जो कि किससे बने थे लीफ और स्टेम से बने दोनों का स्ट्रक्चर क्या है सेम द डिफरेंस इज दैट ओनली इन केस ऑफ एपोस्पोरी इट इज ऑफ द डिप्लॉइड इन नेचर वेयर एज इन दैट दैट वॉज द हैप्लॉइड रेस्ट स्ट्रक्चर इज द सेम सो दैट्स ऑल अबाउट द मॉर्फोलॉजी एनाटॉमी एंड द वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन इन केस ऑफ फ्यूनेरिया Hope you all will understand it very well. Now, these are the some questions that you have to practice on the basis of this topic. Short answer type questions like what do you understand by the protonema? what is apospory, apospory, what is secondary protonema, which plant is known as the cordmos, name a bryophyte which has gamete on rhizoids, why the plants of Fineria hygrometrica grow profusely in recently burnt soil, name the bryophyte in which rhizoids are branched and multicellular. And here are the few long answer type questions. That is, describe the various means of vegetative reproduction, where you have to explain both all the five ways. Write short note on protonema of Fineria. Draw well-labeled diagram of the following: TS of stem or TS of leaf of Fineria. Differentiate between the following: rhizoid of Marchantia and rhizoids of Fineria, moss protonema and the filament of green algae. Now these are the references that I have used for the diagrams and pictures and contents. Thank you.